Okay, you guys, you're gonna freak out. I know you're gonna freak out because I am freaking out. This is the cutest little kind of Cotswolds cottage. And first, what we have is the giant cock. We have the Edward Scissorhands was here, giant topiary. And then this lovely garden. Oh my goodness. This is literally like a fairy tale cottage that you're about to walk into. All the beautiful, look at this. It's hard not to be. It's hard not to be slobbery over the whole thing.
Advertisement on, online when we did Airbnb as a chocolate box. Chocolate box cottage.
Ah, in love, look at the little reading nook. Look at the little reading nook, and then you get to see the big chicken. There he is. The stonework on the front, the garden, fireplace. This is your little garden room. The beautiful arch windows, the light. This is your sitting room. Nobody would want to leave here. This would be it. It. And then, dun, dun, dun. You have the old wall. Hold on. The old wall leads out to that lovely little bit of river. Roses, hawthorn in the distance, and then this lovely little garden. Ah, exquisite, exquisite. And you cross these little stairs out to the arches and the old stone wall. And this is your little garden. Sit out here when the weather's nice and have your tea. There's the little, I'll go around the side of the house then. So this is where, look at that. Is that precious? Is that precious? Oh God. This is the little extra room. You can turn into a little bedroom or a little studio. It's got storage there. And then your washer and dryer out here. And there's another little backyard place with overhang. How precious is that? Okay, here we go. Into the actual house. We go. So you have a bathroom, the clawfoot tub, the claw, yes, and shower behind the door. Shower. So this is these doors, right? They're about as tall as I am. So these doors are about 5'6". Wait till you see this. So now we are back to the living room. We came in this door earlier. Here, we came in that door. So through there is the sitting room and the garden. And then we have this little reading nook and this little reading nook. Ah! fireplace. Cozy, cozy little sitting room welcoming you. And then again, see the ceiling right here? This is, I can pass under, it's fine. So this one might be 5'9", 5'10". Then you're into the baby kitchen. I'm sure the baby kitchen feels all grown up, but it's just so small and cute and cozy. Look at this. Hold on, hold on. Ready, ready. Oh my God! I just want someone to sit there. The sheep from Alice. I want her to knit me something while there's soup on the boil. Oh my God. Then a little pantry through here. Honestly, this is the perfect Green Witch cottage. Or Mrs. Underhill from Little Big. This is your little snuggy dining room. You see the beauty outside. The little river is out there. Your little table, chairs. Precious, precious. Old doors, heavy, beautiful doors, old. Now we go upstairs. Now here's the thing, going upstairs, you see, look at that, the roof is right here. I can touch the roof. This is, right, it's gotta be like maybe six, seven, six, eight, up there. It's very short. Okay, this is where I came in. The back. Hello, Lee. And, well, Lee, would you stand in front of the bathroom so we can see how short that door is? No, just stand in front of it so we can see. How tall are you?
5'11".
You're 5'11". Now come out and stand where we can see your head outside the door. Yeah, inside the door is not helping. So to give you a headache. There it is. Look at that. Look how short those are. Ah. It's a little chocolate box fairy tale house. The stairs are very narrow. They're teeny tiny. And then up here we have, of course, Harry Potter's cupboard. The cupboard at the top of the stairs rather than behind the stairs. There's a little cupboard here for nummy things. Must be Dobby's cupboard. We have bedroom number one. Again, there's our giant bird. See, there's the bird. There he is. See the little river running by? I can hear my husband out there. And then we have these adorable ceilings. The plaster walls. I'm gonna pass out from the fairy tale cuteness of it. I am. This is what I think we would call the master. Again, with the adorable garden down there. Ah, so much adorbs. So much adorbs. And then we have this other little, this would be perfect, it was a nursery. Again, there's my hand. I have to duck and I'm 5'6". Perfect little nursery or cottage or studio. Little closet, little bathroom. That is all. This is the entire thing and it is 0% functionality and 100% adorbs. Silas and I found this online. Well, I did. Pulled him into my web and said, look at this. 0% practicality, 100% charm. You know, those things happen and you're just so tempted. So tempted. Now we will go back outside to the back. cute little garden and bid you adieu through the green door. This little garden. If you don't need to run a business or do a lot functionally with your space, this is just to die for. Love it so much. Back into the sitting room, of course. Who's there? But King Tut.
Me, sitting.
Contemplating. And then we go back around to the front with our giant Edward Scissorhands sculpture and the man who's having a conversation.
We find the end room, the extension we call it, very nice to just sit in and watch the birds in the garden. Because it's an extra lounge, it's, if we have guests coming, you know, visitors, there's plenty of room in there for sitting, and it's quite good.